Happy New Year. It's Brandon. Thanks so much for joining me. I hope all of you are doing awesome so far, this awesome new decade that we are in. So to kick off this year, I'm going to react to Fractalize Immersion. There was a couple of requests out there for me to do this, so I'm pumped to hear this for the first time. I'm going to let you know just as far as a couple of videos that I want to do, something that's just kind of going in my brain. I want to do a few videos on some plugins that I use on a regular basis. And it may be helpful for some of you guys who make music, mix and different things like that. Also, thank you so much for everyone who made an awesome comment or liked the video of Nostalgic Adventure. All right, so let's listen to this. This will be my first time hearing this. So let's start off. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's about to go down. Boy, I sure hope I don't have any buffer problems. Yes. It looks like it's buffering quick enough, so I think we're all right. Just to hit you in the face, I guess. Right off the bat, just gonna hit you in the face. All right. Oh, yeah. Oh, you know what? This reminds me of that band. What's that name of that band? I forgot the name of that band. There's this one band that I listen to sometimes. Oh, wait. Chakran? Is that how you say it? Chakran. I think that's what... Chakran, whatever. Yeah. That's who this reminds me of right here. It's mainly like the background stuff that's going on, I hear. Is he on a 9-string or an 8-string? Somebody let me know in the comments. Kind of sounds like an 8-string, but it could be a 9. I like that background clean sound. Ooh, nice. It kind of breaks it up a little bit. This is one thing I love about this style of music is while you got this, you got this weird syncopation at the whole time this is happening, you got the Spock or the Crash just doing the regular 4-4. I love that. Oh, yep, there's the mosquito. I remember last video. Yep. It's a good snare sound, too. I love that. That's like, it's so percussive and genty, you know? Like the, just that beefy tone. That could be this part right here. That could be like the Emperor, like in Star Wars. That could be like in the throne room or something. Instant. I don't know how you pronounce those first two tracks. I don't know how you would say it. How would you say it? If you were gonna play those first two tracks, what would it be? How would you say it? I guess he's kind of playing the same notes, ain't he? Ooh. that, whoa, ooh, that's scary sounding. Sorry, I'm not saying a whole bunch, but I'm just sitting here enjoying the music. What else can you say? See what I mean? It's like the 4-4, but at the same time, you got the syncopation of the... I like it when songs do that, like everything drops out, you just hear the bass and everything else around it. I expected the guitars to come back in that there, but they didn't. But I bet the guitars will be back in an instant. Oh, nice. I didn't expect that. Very calming. Something's about to happen. Ooh! What'd I tell you? The guitars were back in an instant. Can you imagine how tight his gate has to be on that guitar tone? Ooh, there's something different. Hopefully he's in a different key or something. Yeah, okay. Okay, there we go. That's good. I was gonna say, if it was gonna be the same key, it was gonna get boring there. For that's good. Oh, yeah. He's got the hi-hats on this side. Which, that's good, because you don't always want to have a crash going, you know? Ooh, yeah. I like harmonics. Harmonics, that makes me think of some... I gotta tell you guys a story one day. That'll be another series of videos that we can do. Tell you some funny and cool stories from my past in music, you know. Ooh, yeah, I love that. You got this... surrounding clean tone. Well, this is this person's favorite track right here. Sightless. That's cool. I like that background solo guitar that you can just barely hear on this side. Or maybe it's in the middle. Yeah, I think it's in the middle. Ooh. I like how he just unapologetically has things in the background like that. Oh yeah. That's a floating trim, isn't it? That's gotta be it. It's a whammy bar, man. That's cool. Sounds very alien. Cool. Now here comes another track you could never pronounce. I'll say this. It's cool, but after, it's kind of the same thing. I mean, after a bit, it's like kind of wish for something more, you know. That's one reason why I like progressive stuff. Progressive stuff as in like, I don't know, like Periphery, I don't know, something, you know, or Era, you know, has different things that. And I know he's changing up a bit too, but it's not so progressive all the time. But it's cool though. It may not be something I want to listen to all the time, but it's cool though. But yeah, Sightless, I'd say Sightless so far was my favorite too, just like this person said. I'll say this, I would be afraid to write something in this way because I'm so self-conscious, and I'd be afraid that people would say, oh, this is too repetitive or whatever, but obviously there's a group of people that would want to listen to this over and over on a repetitive basis. And I know I'm starting to say like almost like I don't like it, but I am starting to get bored. Because it's a lot of the same thing over and over, but it's good background music, I would say. For like, oh, I don't know, maybe a video game or something. So we got two more tracks. Hopefully these are a little bit more varied and different than what it has been so far, but we'll see. Oh, he's in the same key, I think. But there's different rhythms, so I guess that's what this is all about. It's different. It's rhythmic. It's rhythmic, you know, different rhythms and stuff. Ooh, nice. I like that. Really fast stuff. This is my favorite type of djent stuff to write that's, you know, faster like this. You know, it's got the off feeling kind of stuff. I can't really write that for my band though, because my drummer hates me when I do that, which I don't blame him. All I gotta do is do this. He's gotta do all this other stuff, you know? Respect to drummers who can do four things at once. I can't even. Okay, this is cool, this is nice. That's an envelope right there. Gradual change. I liked that fill right there. That was a cool different variation of the drums. I'm not good at writing fills on MIDI drums. Cool. All right, well, one more track. Don't fail me now. Come on. Let's go out with a bang. Fragment. Okay, come on. Let's do this. Let's do this. Lowest note possible. That's funny. I like how mature his palm muting is. It's just really, really good. Like, I'm still working on my palm muting even after, 10 years of playing, whatever it is. 11 years, I don't know what it is, but. Oh, there you go. That's what I was looking for, something that's different. Some parts of this reminds me also of Modern Day Babylon, which they're pretty cool. Modern Day Babylon are a lot more varied though, a lot more progressive. Again, this is cool, but this does get repetitive after a while. It's not just like one song that I reacted to that day. This is like 20 minutes or whatever of very similar stuff. But it's cool. It's still cool. It's good stuff to listen to when you're changing strings. This is neat. This is some syncopation, if I've ever heard any. Oh yeah. How is it gonna wrap up in 8 seconds, though? That's cool. Oh, did it? It stopped. Okay. I guess, yeah, it didn't. Okay, well, anyway, I would have preferred maybe more of an ambient ending, because that kind of ended up abruptly or whatever, but hey, that's cool. Hey, maybe this is just a partial album or something. Somebody was talking about there was like 31 tracks or something. I can't remember who commented that and what that was, where that was, but if that was Fractalize, I don't know. But anyways, yeah, like I say, pretty cool. It does get repetitive after a bit. This is me personally. Whatever that guy's name is, I don't know what his real name is, but the guy of Fractalize, good job. I love the production in it. That's one thing that I have struggled with. Part of the reason why I went away from 8 strings was because production was a lot harder to achieve a good guitar tone and everything, because, you know, everything is so low and pitch shifted, as opposed to just a 7-string, which a 7-string, I'm down in drop G right now. It's still pretty low, but it's still okay and easy enough to get a good tone, as opposed to like a low E or a D or whatever he's tuned to, for example. So yeah, awesomeness. For those who are still here, thank you so much for you being still here. You are a super fan, obviously, for you to still be here. Most people have not, have left the video. But yeah, that'll be all. Thank you so much for watching. More videos to come in the 2020. That's my plan anyway. So yeah, see you guys. You have a good one.